This movie may hold the key to something people spend their whole lives chasing, but that's because Frozen isn't your average Disney princess movie. Sure, it's about love, loyalty, and sisterhood, but if you know me, I don't settle for surface level. I think we can go deeper. In this video, I'm spilling the tea on how Disney's Frozen taps into the realm of inner child healing using Elsa and Anna. This is the key to elevating your relationships and finding that deep-seated fulfillment that we're all after. So buckle up, hit that like button, and let's uncover the secrets behind this movie with a message. Meet Elsa. Elsa was born with magical powers that allow her to manipulate snow and ice. A super exciting gift that created a fun, snow-filled childhood for both her and her sister Anna. Until the day Elsa slipped on ice and accidentally popped Anna in the head. Surprisingly, the king and queen, their parents, knew just what to do to get Anna some help. So they leave their quaint kingdom of Arendelle and they rush Anna to the forest in an effort to find some trolls that know how to reverse Elsa's magic. In a spiritual context, snow and ice are linked to the element of water, which symbolizes the realms of feeling and emotions. Which means Elsa's powers are intricately tied to how well she can harness and manage her emotions. Similar to when people have gifts like empathy, creativity, leadership, energy reading, these are all blessings that can easily turn to curses if you don't know how to manage your emotions. After healing Anna, the trolls warn Elsa that fear will be her enemy, with a light show that pretty much strikes fear into her little childhood heart. This prompts the king and queen to take extreme measures to help Elsa manage her emotions, which unfortunately results in Elsa's isolation and attempted suppression of her gifts. Now, meet Anna. She and Elsa were inseparable as kids. They had these awesome childhood memories filled with laughter, snow, and fun. But now Elsa's isolated in her room with no explanation. Lame, right? To add to it, Arendelle's basically closed, and the castle no longer allows visitors. Also lame. So Anna passes the time imagining the day she can break free and experience the warmth, fun, and connection that she's been craving. Fast forward to Anna and Elsa's teenage years, and the king and queen set sail. And they vanish, never to be seen again, leaving Elsa to step into her role as Queen of Arendelle much earlier than expected. Elsa's long-awaited coronation day breaks the silence and sets the scene for a pivotal moment between both sisters, opening the door for them to interact with the outside world and for us to watch the messages unfold. But before we get into that, we have to talk about the heart chakra. While my Moana video discussed cultivating the strong heart, Frozen taps into balancing the open heart, which is the chamber of the heart chakra that holds the essence of your inner child. It embraces self-expression and pursues joy, all while opening you up to the abundant goodness that life has to offer. If you want to find more resources on the chambers of the heart chakra, you can find them in the blog post I've linked below on my site, tendingyourtransformation.com. The crazy thing is, it's possible to be completely unaware of how your imbalanced heart chakra affects your life. This is why it's critical to understand the message in Disney's Frozen. Because while you may be unaware, the effects are unavoidable and they will rear their ugly head in an area of life that we cannot ignore, our connections with others. Opening the gates becomes Elsa's worst nightmare. Fear of slipping up and being seen hovers over her like a dark cloud. She can't let loose and she definitely can't let anyone get too close. So when Anna comes to Elsa and asks, why can't it be like this all the time? Elsa's like, hell nah, girl. Enjoy this while it lasts. Elsa's heart chakra is, you guessed it, underactive. The heart chakra is the most common chakra to have out of balance. So if you resonate with Elsa and you break into a cold sweat at the thought of sharing your feelings, are somewhat shy and antisocial, disappear and self-isolate, and tend to give everyone the side eye, you may want to look deeper into what it means to have an underactive heart chakra. Coronation day for Anna feels like a dream, and she's not even the one getting crowned. Finally, she can vibe with people and experience the warmth and connection that she's been missing. And maybe, just maybe, she'll experience a little romance. But most importantly, it's an opportunity for her to celebrate her sister, the person who brought her childhood pure joy. Even though she became a closed door, leaving Anna to deal with her formative years and the loss of her parents alone. But even through all that, Anna understands that people have needs, and she's got to accommodate them for the sake of the connection. Anna has an overactive heart chakra and has learned to find her joy in other people. So when Elsa drops the bomb that opening the gates is a one-time deal, Anna's like, I'll be damned if I keep living like this. If you resonate with Anna or you find yourself as super empathetic, boundary challenged, putting everyone else's needs above your own, and a bit clingy or codependent, you might want to look into what it means to have an overactive heart chakra. I want to add a disclaimer and mention that just because you resonate with one or the other does not mean that you are stuck. The younger me totally would have been Team Anna until my teenage years hit. However, regardless of the past, your personal power can bring it back into balance. If you want to treat a heart chakra, holistic methods are definitely the way to go. But if you want to heal on a soul level, watch how Anna and Elsa step out of those old karmic cycles. A karmic cycle involves the repetition of events or emotions until a spiritual lesson is learned. Once you identify and begin to step out of the karmic cycle by choosing differently, you begin to acquire wisdom at a soul level. Throughout the movie, Anna and Elsa play out their karmic cycles. Just watch the pivotal scene that illustrates the beginning of Elsa's karmic cycle.
Elsa, what have you done? This is getting out of hand.
As children, we understand that our emotions can create beautiful connections. However, the experience and internalization of fear can often cause us to shut down how we express ourselves. Like Elsa, if you aren't taught to handle fear-based emotions constructively, it's going to be a challenge trying to control them, which will then cause hurt, fear, and pain in others. Elsa's father teaches her to suppress all of her emotions. So Elsa develops this belief that her emotions, her powers, cause other people pain, compelling her to keep them hidden. Feeling trapped, Elsa isolates herself, creating a physical and emotional barrier between her and everything she cares about, thus keeping the karmic cycle from playing out. Or so she thinks. In reality, the cycle still plays out. Elsa's fear intensifies because it hasn't been addressed, leading to continued isolation, which still causes Anna pain. And instead of external persecution for the pain she's caused, she persecutes herself by locking herself away. I'll break down their karmic cycles in detail in another video. Just drop a comment if you're interested. But for Elsa specifically, she's stuck in her karmic cycle until her coronation day, when Anna does something unexpected. Anna's love for her sister knew no bounds. Their carefree childhood days were filled with laughter and adventure. That is until Elsa got her own room. She no longer wanted to play, and the king and queen never said a word about it. Despite Anna's persistent attempts to pull her sister out of her room, she was always met with the same response. And obediently, Anna returned to her now very quiet home. Anna spent a large amount of her childhood sacrificing her need for connection to submit to Elsa's need for space. Karmic cycles usually start from way back, usually in memories we can't even remember. And Anna keeps reaching out to Elsa because she feels like she needs her. Because when Elsa was around, Anna's inner child was happy. And this whole karmic drama continues until Elsa's coronation day. On coronation day, Elsa pushes Anna away again. Only this time, Anna has met Hans. Hans gives Anna a taste of everything she thinks she's been missing. Fun, excitement, and connection. He turns her world upside down. They even bond over a shared wound of feeling invisible, shut out from the world that they think they deserve. And for the first time in forever, Anna feels seen. So this must be love, right? Anna just knows that her sister will be stoked about her marriage. But again, she gets the cold shoulder. Elsa tells the staff to close the gates, but this time Anna does something different. She speaks her truth. Anna speaks up about her needs instead of submitting to what Elsa needs. And this small act triggers a massive change that goes beyond just her. Elsa can finally take a deep breath now that her coronation is complete. She held it together through the ceremony, and once this party's over, she can head back to the safety of her isolation. But hold on, Anna's back. And she wants to marry a complete stranger? Concerned, Elsa tries to advise Anna privately, but Anna's frustration boils over. She speaks her truth, expressing her unhappiness. Anna's never done this before. Doesn't she understand that Elsa's only trying to keep her safe? Elsa locks the best of herself away just to keep everyone safe, just for Anna to tell her that she's unhappy? This
unexpected event floods Elsa's emotions to the point where she can no longer hide them. And now one of her worst fears unfolds. Outsiders want to persecute her for her powers. And Elsa decides to break free from the kingdom she's felt has been holding her hostage. Elsa retreats to isolation again, only this time it's different. This time, Elsa ascends the mountain, a spiritual symbol of the path of enlightenment and ascension. Various cultures have associated mountains with temples, gods, and deities, in the belief that the higher you were, the closer you were to the heavens is observed by many, and reaching the summit leaves you transformed forever. Elsa's escape allows her to master her emotions without judgment and persecution. In her ice palace, she reconnects with her inner child, creating a space that the childhood version of her would have loved. Leaving behind all expectations, Elsa finally embraces her emotions. Anna's devastated that her normally reserved sister has kept this huge secret. She was all set to live the dream with Hans, the open gates, the parties. Elsa ascends the mountain and Anna's like, hold up, what do I really want? Which causes Anna to take off after her sister. Along the way, Anna bumps into Kristoff, an ice harvester who needs a little help. Anna strikes a deal, but this time she boldly lays out her needs and expectations. She sets a boundary, one Kristoff can't ignore. If your heart chakra is overactive, setting boundaries may not be your cup of tea. You kind of tend to go with the flow, neglecting your needs for the sake of others. But take this one from Anna, because once she starts expressing her needs and setting boundaries, her ascension takes off. As a result, she's able to build a balanced relationship with Kristoff from the get-go. When Anna shows up to Elsa's ice palace with Olaf in hand, Elsa faces the moment that her inner child learned her powers weren't safe. Anna's presence makes Elsa realize that while she's liberated herself, she's left everyone else out in the cold. The inner child seeks love and connection just as much as it craves creativity and emotional expression. Unintentionally striking Anna's hearts symbolizes that we replay traumatizing moments until we choose to heal. It also highlights that an underactive heart chakra lacking emotional control can also cause harm to others in their heart space. On the flip side, when your heart chakra is overactive, you can leave yourself vulnerable to hurt and exploitation. Even at the mountain's summit, the karmic cycle repeats and Elsa shuts Anna out once again. Anna and Kristoff get kicked out of the castle, making the never-ending winter the least of their problems. Anna's heart is iced out, and the only cure is an act of true love, according to the trolls. Kristoff races Anna back to the castle because Anna needs Hans, her true love, but the Anna that returns is not the same Anna that left for the mountain. She's leveled up, taking major steps out of her karmic cycle. You see, Hans of the Southern Isles was able to easily sweep her off her feet because Anna romanticized him into being her savior from loneliness. They enter a type of karmic relationship where their bond is established on mutual wounds. But Anna wakes up after her inner work in her journey up the mountain, and Hans's mask falls. Now Anna's left alone, wondering if she knows what love really is. Elsa, left alone to have her anxiety attack in her palace, prepares for persecution for her gifts once again. But this time, at the mountain's peak, she throws in the towel. When you surrender, you actively give up control. Elsa decides she's done trying to fight the fear in others. She decides not to let the fear others have determine who she becomes. Then captured and brought back to Arendelle, Elsa still has yet to figure out how to deal with her internal fears. The storm in Arendelle worsens, and Hans pushes Elsa to face her childhood nightmare, causing her sister's demise. Elsa realizes her greatest fear has come true, and the storm stands still. Elsa hasn't been able to overcome her karmic cycle because she hasn't learned how to transmute fear. To transmute fear, you have to feel it, along with all the other emotions that accompany it. When Elsa sees Anna turn to ice, she feels it all. But the ice doesn't melt just yet. Anna's last shot at saving her heart involves finding Kristoff. But when Anna notices Elsa in trouble, her newfound understanding of true love, thanks to Kristoff, prompts her to act from her heart, despite past pain. And this selfless act of unconditional love is what Elsa needs to finally transmute that fear. As a result, Anna and Elsa are able to attract everything they've ever longed for. Elsa discovers that the vibration of love conquers fear, which enables her to embrace joy and fulfillment in her authentic self-expression. allowing her to build more genuine connections with others. Meanwhile, Anna realizes that advocating for herself and setting boundaries is the key to open up the door for the relationships that she's desired. Stepping out of their karmic cycles and taking responsibility for their own lessons allows the sisters to have everything they want. As karma balances out, they find themselves relating to each other on much better terms, opening the door for a more harmonious and fulfilling future. All right, love ya. Balance out your heart chakra, get your ego in check. If you liked this one, then you'll love the one I did about Inside Out. As always, I'm sending love and healing your way. Bye.